Hello, Butts and Books fans, this is Scorp1701, and with all the awesome Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles news that has been dropping lately, what with new figures released at Target and Walmart, and NECA announcing the release of the awesome Turtle Van, I thought what better time to take a look at the Walmart exclusive NECA Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie 2-packs featuring Leonardo, Donatello, and Raphael and Michelangelo. And these 2-packs are awesome and they're so big I'm barely able to squeeze them both into the review station at the same time. So we're going to take a look at all of these turtles tonight, and I think this is just going to be a totally tubular time. All right, so let's get started. And taking a look at the first box set, we have Leonardo and Donatello, and you can see it is in this awesome window box. It is mimicking the movie poster of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie with the turtles looking up out of the sewer, and you got the buildings on the side, so that is very cool. You have Nickelodeon here, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie logo there. You have Leonardo, you have Donatello, and you have them in there, and you can see them with their accessories. That is so cool. On the top of the box, you just have NECA and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles warnings and real toys. On the side of the box, you have Donatello looking all grr, you have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you have Donatello looking ah, and then NECA again. On the other side of the box, you have Leonardo's head, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you have Leonardo looking ah, and then you have NECA. On the bottom of the box, you just have some credits for the box and a barcode, nothing too great. And on the back of the box, you have some awesome shots of Leonardo and Donatello, and you have a quick read up of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and we will scroll in and we will see what it has to say. I will focus that in. You can pause this and read it to your heart's desire, but we must be moving on. So going back out, that is it for the Leonardo and Donatello box. And that brings us to the Raphael Michelangelo box, which is virtually the same box, just has different character pictures on it, but we'll go through it anyway. You have Nickelodeon up here, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles there, you have the guys, you have Raphael Michelangelo on the top of the box, you have NECA, you have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you have warnings and real toys. On the right side of the box, you have Michelangelo, you have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you have Michelangelo full pose, you have NECA. On the other side of the box, you have Raphael, you have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you have Raphael looking all rrr, and you have NECA. On the bottom of the box, you just have some credits for the box and a barcode. And finally, bringing us to the back of the box, you have some awesome product shots of the toys and another read up. And we will zoom in there because this is actually a different read up. And let me focus. Now, you can pause the video, read this to your heart's content, but we must be moving on. This is a great looking box. These are both great looking boxes, but nobody wants to see these awesome turtles in these boxes. I know I don't. So let's get them out and see what they can do. And here we have the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles out of the box, and out of the box they all stand approximately 6.5 inches tall, and they are so cool looking. They each come with their signature weapons. They each come with 2 alternate bandanas, a set of alternate hands, which are interchangeable with all the turtles, and a piece of pizza. And we'll take a look at all of that in just a minute, but first I want to take a good look at the turtles themselves, starting with my main man, Leonardo. And coming in real close on Leonardo, I think they did a fantastic job with the way this guy looks. And these turtles are going to have the same molding and sculpt. I think there is going to be a slight difference when it comes to the paint apps and obviously the head sculpt and the belts, because each of their belts do different things. But starting off with Leonardo here, he looks great. I love the way they did this. He looks exactly like he did in the movie. And even though the turtles were all the same, they all did have very slight differences when it comes to their face and head sculpt. And this is no difference. You can see he has a nice blue bandana, and I love it. It's very long. It comes down here over his shoulders. And here's the part in the back where it can pop off, and we'll get to that later. here. Has some nice eyes peeking out of there. Nice grim face. And nice green coming down. You have a nice neck. A lot of muscle details in there. You can see a little bit of paint wash and black. You got some spots here on the shoulder. I think this is going to be different. I think you're going to have spots on the turtles in different places. And coming down, you have the nice brown belt, and it sits a little higher than I like, but I guess in the movie it had to be sitting high because that's practical. And you have the straps coming across the shoulders, and that will bring us back to the actual sword holders. And I got the katanas in there, and they're really nice. They stick up high. And yeah, he can actually move his arm back in order to grab those katanas. I did test that. So that is cool. Only thing I don't like about these katana holders here is that there's an open spot right here at the top. And I guess that helps get the katanas in and out better. But I think I would have liked this open spot better if it was like flipped around and you didn't really see that. But then you'd see it from the back, from the front. So, yeah. I guess if you're going to have it, I guess having it on the back actually would be the better. So that is cool. And taking a look back to the front, nice burnt orange for the shell. And this shell piece is really cool. It goes all the way around and attaches to the back. And I love that. It's broke up into the sections. And the back of the shell is done in some nice detail. And it looks like a real turtle shell. I really like the way that they did this particular style of the shell. That is so cool. And what is also interesting is you can see a little bit of green attachment where the shell kind of forms onto his back here. So this is a darker green to see that. That is cool. And then coming down, you have, instead of multicolored armbands and elbow pads, you just have this brown realistic looking pad, which is good. It's more prone to what they would have in real life, so that is cool. And coming down, got some more details in the legs, a lot of good muscular detail. And then you got your knee pads, and then coming down to your feet, nice two toes. And these are really large feet, so I think that's good to help him stand up. And again, taking a look at the back, nothing really different over here. You got some nice calf muscles. Wow, this guy is awesome. All right, and that is Leonardo. And next up we have Michelangelo, the party dude. And coming in real close on him, we can see they continue to do a great job on these head sculpts by just a slight variation on the mask and the eyes. As you can see, Michelangelo's mask is wider at the eyes, and you can see his eyes in there, which gave him a more of a happy-go-lucky look. And he's got a nice smile. I love that. Same bandana coming on over his shoulders. Love that. His chest is open a lot more than Leonardo's was because there's no straps going around, and you can see that there's a good wash on his shell. So you got a little bit of black in there. It makes it look all dingy and dirty and worn, I guess. And then coming down, nothing different about this guy when it comes to the sculpt on the legs and the molds of the arms. The sides are going to be the same too. I put his nunchucks here, attached them to the inside of his belt. There wasn't really a holder for them on the back, but if we go around to the back, we can see a better look at the shell without the swords being there. And wow, again, love this detail on the shell. This is very, very realistic of what a turtle shell looks like. I love this. Wow. Okay. And that is gonna be your Michelangelo. And that brings us to Donatello. And this is, again, still a nice sculpt. He kind of has this smug look on his face. And I love the purple that they did here. It kind of goes from a light to a dark. Very nice, again, coming over the shoulders with the bandana. You have one strap here on his belt as opposed to Leonardo's two straps, so that makes it a little different and a little thicker. I like that. And coming around to the back, you can see that his bow staff fits nicely into the little straps. It is the same size, just not as long as the staff I use to point things out, and this is Gambit's staff from Marvel Legends, but that is really nicely done. We'll look at that a little later. And shell detail, again, this is going to be pretty much the same sculpt and mold. It's just what you want to look at is the belt and the face detail, and those are going to be your different aspects of each turtle. And again, the weapon holding system, so that is unique to Donatello. All right, moving on. And that brings us to one other fellow, Raphael. And as we zoom in on this very angry, angsty turtle, you can see that they gave him some very angry, squinty eyes, and he looks like he's going to mess somebody up, which is what he likes to do. That and run off and getting captured and in trouble. So anyway, take a look at him. He has some nice details around his face. Looks like he has a lot of freckle marks up here on the sides of his face. And his bandana, again, like everybody else's, comes straight down over his shoulder. And coming down to his belt, it is similar to Michelangelo's, but he does actually have some side holds here in the side of his belt, so they fit in really nicely there. And for the most part, everything else is going to be the same when it comes to Raphael's sculpt and mold gun around the back. Nice look at the shell, and that is going to be what your Raphael looks like. All right, moving on. And for articulation, we will basically do one and be done, because all the turtles have the same articulation. So we will use Michelangelo here, because he's not going to be as hindered by having straps go across his shoulder like Leonardo and Donatello. Not that they are hindered a lot, it's just going to be easier if we use him. All right, starting with the head, Michelangelo's head can go around 360 degrees. Just mind the headband straps. Strips, whatever you want to call them, and his head can look up a little bit, and it can look down a long way, so that is cool. He can look to the left, he can look to the right. This head does a lot of good wiggle waggle. About the only thing this head can't do is pop down into its shell like it did in the movie, but hey, that's asking, I think, too much for the toy. All right, coming around to the back, the headband strips are articulated too, so these can kind of go around, especially when you have the other ones on. So that's how that could be. We'll look at that in accessories. Coming down to the shoulders, shoulders can go around 360 degrees. They are on a hinge, so they can come out from the body a little bit and then back in. There is no bicep swivel. That will bring us down to the elbow joint. It is a single elbow joint. Does not give us exactly 90 degrees, but it's good for what it is. But built into the elbow joint is a rotation, so you got a forearm rotation right there that will bring us down to the wrist, and the wrist will go around 360 degrees, and depending on which wrist you have, it will be articulated in and out, up or down, however you want to put it. All right, coming to the chest, there is no articulation in this chest because this is a solid piece, and unlike the NECA Toon Turtles, you cannot move this top part around. I did try, there is a little bit of give, so you can kind of see the shoulders and the top part moving left and right, but you can't really do anything else with it. So that will bring us down to the legs. Legs can come up just a little bit. There's not a lot of room for the legs to come up because of the shell, and definitely not any room in the back because that shell is going to cut you off. He does have a slight thigh rotation, but it does not go all the way around. And that will bring us down to the knees, and the knees maybe on a double hinge. I can't really tell because of the knee pad, but I think it's just a single like the elbow, and you still barely get maybe 90 out of that, so that's still pretty neat. And that will bring us down to the foot, and the foot can go forward a long way, and it can come up, and it can rock around 360 degrees, so that is pretty neat. No toe articulation, although there is enough room in this foot to have it, they just don't. All right, and that is going to be your turtle articulation. And for accessories, taking a look at Leonardo's katana blades, you can see they are nicely done. You have two of them, and they are painted in a nice silver all the way down to the hilt. And then the handles are done in a nice black with some molded detail in there, looking like there is a nice wrapping on it. And you do got a little bit of silver dots, I guess. And that is really cool. And he can store these really well. He looks really nice with them in the back of his sheath. And like I said, when we turn them around, I don't particularly like the open at the top, but I guess it has to be there if it helps getting the swords out. So that's really nice. And he holds them. He can hold them both, and he could do a cross pose, and then he could just point, hey, he's the guy. And only problem on my copy with the swords, and this may be different depending on your copy, but this one goes in really well on the right side, but the left sheath is really tight to go in, and it feels like maybe the pathway wasn't cut as good, because it really takes some doing to get it into this particular side. And I think that's a bummer. So I'm just going to leave this out for now. But that is something to look out for if you have your Leonardos. Moving on. And the next accessories I want to take a look at are Michelangelo's nunchucks. And they're nicely done for what they are. And basically you have two little brown pieces of wood. I guess it's plastic, but it's painted to brown to look like wood. And you have a little bendy wire in the middle so that the nunchucks can move in different directions. And this is a really nice idea. I do feel a little uneasy about it, like maybe over time that is going to be a weak point and break on you. But that's always been the problem with Michelangelo's nunchucks, unless you use like actual little plastic chain or real chain. But anyway, you can put these in the side of Michelangelo's belt. You can just hang them over the loop there. It looks really nice. And he can hold them really well in the hands that are provided for him. So yeah, it's really neat. And those are going to be Michelangelo's nunchucks. And that brings us to Donatello's bow staff, and it's pretty nicely done. It is 5.5 inches, and you do have a thicker part here in the middle that looks like it's wrapped. And all it's just painted in a nice brown paint, a little bit of darker brown for the middle section. And like I was saying before, it does seem to be about the same size and shape as the Gambit staff from Marvel Legends. The Gambit staff is just slightly longer, as you can see here. It's about 6 inches. And yeah, and it's a pretty neat looking bow staff. Donatello can store it on his back. It looks really awesome when it's stored there. You can see it from the side and you can see it from the back. It's just pushed through those little string attachments, and he can hold it really well with one hand, and he can hold it with both hands. And that's gonna be Donatello's bow. And finally, we come to Raphael's size, and these are nicely done. You have a pair of them, and they are done with a nice silver blade. And then you have the two hooks coming down to the handle, and those are done in a black with some molded detail in there. And that is really cool. And they're not that sharp, so don't worry about poking yourself. But Raphael can store them on the side of his belt. Like I said before, he does have holsters for them built into the belt, and he can hold them really nice in different various positions. And I think these are some very, very deadly ninja weapons. Haha! And for alternate hands, first pair we're going to take a look at are these special Sai holding hands. And as you can see, you can equip them to Raphael, and they have a finger pointing out, and it lets him hold his size in a neat particular manner. So if you're looking to do that, they included the hands for you to do so. And the next set of hands we have are these wider open hands. You can use them to make it easier to hold Donatello's bow if you want to, but they're also could be used for holding other bigger items. Or maybe if you pose them right, they could be for like karate poses or maneuvers. So yeah, that is the wider open hands. And another set of alternate hands the turtles come with is the thumbs up hands. And these are really cool for when Michelangelo sees somebody doing something really cool. Or, yay, good job. Thumbs up, dude. Yay. So those are neat if you like to have your turtles do thumbs up. And the last set of hands we have are the open hands. And these are really nice for doing ninjutsu moves or meditating or, you know, clapping, you know, and maybe doing some ninjutsu dance. Oh, well, that's not really one of Leonardo's things, I don't think. But anyway, they still look good on him. So those are your alternate hands. And the next figure accessory we have are the alternate headbands. Now, your standard headband has two sides to it, and usually it will come down off the shoulders. But you have alternate headbands where you can affix, and they can do different things. Both of the straps can be pointed to the right. Both of the straps can be pointed to the left. Some of the straps can be pointed straight up and down. And it's just a variety of different headband straps that you got. And they can do all sorts of neat things. So there is a slew of different ones that come with these turtles. So that gives it a little more option to play. And I really like the different things that you could do with these alternate headbands. And for the last accessory the turtles come with, they each come with a slice of pizza. And this is really nicely done. You can see it looks like the one from the movie. It had some black olives, some onions, and some peppers on it. And it all the same sculpt and mold. The paint apps are just slightly different on some of them because they didn't get painted as well. Like this one, you can't really see any of the black olives, but you can see them on the others. So anyway, that is pretty cool. Every good turtle needs some pizza to fight the foot with. And yeah, that is your pizza accessory. And full comparison, here you have the Neca Movie Turtles with the Super 7 Turtles. And this is where you got the Movie Turtles versus the Toy Turtles. And it's not too bad, I guess. The Super 7 Turtles are a little smaller, and you can tell that they have that different shading to them. But there's going to be a big difference between something based on a toy as opposed to something from a live-action movie where it's supposed to be an actual real version of it. All right, moving on. And for another comparison, here you have the NECA Movie Turtles with the NECA Toon Turtles. And you can see, again, there's a big difference between something that's live action and supposed to be real, as opposed to something that you see in a cartoon series. This is a cool set of turtles, though. No matter which series you prefer, NECA is there to accommodate. All except for the toy turtle. That's Super 7. All right, moving on. And finally, you can't have a Ninja Turtle collection without having Master Splinter. And a few years ago, when the Mutagen Tour box set came out, or the coming out of their shells figures came out, I went ahead and bought him so I could put him up with them. But he fits right here, and he looks great. And these look great, and I really love these figures. Moving on. And this has been the Walmart exclusive NECA Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Movie Turtle 2-Packs with Leonardo and Donatello and Raphael and Michelangelo. And you couldn't ask for a better representation of the 1990s Movie Turtles than these figures that are before your eyes. They are great. The sculpt and the mold is fantastic. The articulation is good. Not that great with the legs, but you can't do much with that because the big huge shell gets in the way. But the head can move all sorts of ways. The colors, the little detail that they put into the paint job on these things, fantastic and great. Now, these are definitely collector's items. I don't know if they would sustain playability because I think there are a lot of things on these figures that wouldn't hold up through continuous use. Like I said before, Michelangelo's nunchucks are on a bendy wire. I think that would eventually break. I did have a casualty with the turtle hands. The Raphael hand with the sai, it kind of snapped right at the peg, so I lost both of those. But that just kind of made me remember that when you're dealing with NECA figures particularly, you might want to heat them up first when you're trying to manipulate the arms or pull things out. I did use a hair dryer after that first incident, and I didn't have any problems after that. These figures have been around for a while before Walmart got a hold of them. I think they were originally released in a 4-pack that looked like a VHS cassette tape of the original movie, and then I think GameStop got them, and finally now Walmart is selling them in 2-packs. So yeah, they have been around for a while. So if you haven't got them, I didn't get them until this year, so they're still out there. If you're looking for them, check your Walmarts. They sporadically put them on the shelves. They're $60 a set, so that's $120. Or you can wait till next year when the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2 Secret of the Ooze 4-pack comes out. So it's up to you. I saw these on the shelf and I kind of wanted to have them for size comparison when I reviewed my other turtles. But I'm pretty much all done now. I did pre-order the Secret of the Ooze 4-pack, so when those come in, I'll review those and we'll compare them with these and the other Ninja Turtles. So yeah, it is a good time to be a Ninja Turtle collector. There's a lot of stuff out there on the market. But anyway, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. If you're looking for them, happy hunting, have a great night, and until next time, keep playing.
Do you stand for what you believe in and find the strength to do what's right? That's turtle power.